what I would love for elementary school teachers to know about autistic girls is that there is a level of masking. And so looking for the typical things like a lack of eye contact, that's not gonna help. I don't make particularly atypical eye contact, but I do look off when I think a lot, or I might look sort of in the center of the face. So it's not as obvious. A lot of times you're going to see things that aren't as obvious. If we're playing, if the kids play, you might want to notice that a lot of times it's a scripted play. So they're playing out either nonfiction scenarios, or they're literally repeating things from their favorite cartoon or whatever it might be. And other kids aren't going to know what to do with that. And so there's a reciprocity in play, especially with girls verbally. And that is going to be a challenge for any girl on the spectrum, no matter how amazing her vocabulary, that interactive, spontaneous play, that's going to be a challenge. So supporting, teaching social rules, it's a bit like being born where everybody else has the rules to the game of life, and somehow they've forgotten to give them to you. And so understanding that you have for you probably one of the most empathetic kids you're going to have ever. But things will come out wrong. Things will come out sounding either self-centered or self-congratulatory, or sometimes even cold. And they're not meant that way. It's simply that if you cannot literally put yourself in someone else's shoes without being told first what that experience is like, you can't empathize in the same way. You have to rationalize it first. Once we rationalize it, once we have someone explain, you know what, let's stop and think about for just a minute, what is that like for somebody else on the receiving end? What might that look like? Aha moments happen. And then you're going to have a kid who is so wanting to be everybody's caretaker, because they're going to want to be the kindest person in the class. But when you don't know how to do that naturally, it just comes off as not particularly fun to be around. And if every teacher could just believe in that innate empathy and simply help quell the anxiety, which is just omnipresent, and help teach to look around that other perspective, that literally could be life-changing and life-saving.
For more information about social and emotional learning, please visit readingrockets.org.